Hola, 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 my dear amigos. Welcome back to Learning Spanish World. My name is Mr. Briggs. I'm a qualified Spanish teacher and I'm here today to help you learn all about mexicanismos. We're going to travel to the beautiful lands of Mexico. Today is going to be a very special episode.
I extend you a warm welcome, amigos. Click the subscribe button and join us.
Today, we're going to learn all about Mexican slang. Número uno. Number one. ¿Estás listo? Are you ready? Muy bien. Comencemos. Ándale. Ándale. It uses hurry up, go. It can also be used in order to get somebody's attention or somebody to start doing something quickly. Ándale, ándale. Ándale. Número dos. Number two. Are you ready, mi cuate? Are you ready, my friend? Apapachar. Apapachar is an indigenous word which means to cuddle in a caring manner. Come here, you need to be apapachado. Apapachar. Repite, apapachar. Número 3. Number 3. Número 3. Number 3. Chido. Qué chido, wey. Chido means something very cool, beautiful, or very good. You can simply say, qué chido, how cool. Chido, cool. Número 4. Number 4. Número 4. Chingón. Chingón. Someone or something nice, good, or incredibly good. Chingón. Repite. Chingón. Número 5. Number 5. Fresa. Fresa. Fresa is someone who belongs to a higher social status. Someone well-educated, generally wealthier than the average person. When somebody is called a fresa, that person is being called upper class. Número 6. Number 6. Número 6. Güey. You will hear this word in Mexico all the time. The palabra, the word güey, is used to call someone a friend, a mate. Used to talk about any type of person regardless of gender or age. For example, ¿qué onda, güey? ¿Cómo estás? What's up, mate? How's it going? Or how are you? Güey. Número 7. Number 7. Let's continue learning Mexican Spanish. Órale. Órale is a very common expression in Mexico. You'll hear it all the time. It is an exclamation expressing approval or encouragement. Órale, güey. Órale. Número 8. Number 8. Let's keep enhancing our Mexican Spanish knowledge. Padrísimo. Padrísimo is used to express that something is amazing, cool, or fantastically good. This is padrísimo. The fact that you're watching this video and subscribing is padrísimo. So what are you waiting for? Subscribe. Número 9. Number 9. Número 9. Pendejo. Pendejo is an insult meaning stupid or idiot. Oh, this pendejo. Oh, this idiot. Pendejo. Número 10. Number 10. Número 10. Pinche. Pinche. It's also an insulting word used to express that something or someone is insignificant, lousy, miserable, or worthless. Ouch. Pinche. Fantástico, muy bien. We've arrived at section número 2, typical Mexican expressions. This will help you to gain a more deeper, profound knowledge of the typical expressions used in Mexico today. So, are you ready? Vámonos. Me vale madre. Who cares? I don't give a damn. Me vale madre. Repite. Repeat. Me vale madre. Me vale madre. Siguiente, next one. Es la neta. It is the absolute truth. Es la neta. Es la absoluta verdad. It is the absolute truth. Es la neta. It's like Ferdinand in Australian English. No mames. No mames expresses shock, surprise, in relation to something hard to believe. Get out of here. No way. Are you serious? No mames. No mames. Repite. No mames. Siguiente, next one. Ya nos cayó el cahuistle. When someone or something ruins your plans, is also used when someone is caught doing something wrong, as in when someone is caught red-handed. Ya nos cayó el cahuistle. Eché la hueva todo el día. When someone does absolutely nothing all day long, used to describe having a lazy day. Bludging. Eché la hueva todo el día. Muy bien, let's continue. Voy a chacharear un rato. To go out to buy cheap things. Chacharear, buying cheap things. Voy a, I'm going to, chacharear un rato, buy cheap things. Me hace lo que el viento a Juárez. Me hace lo que el viento a Juárez means when someone doesn't care about being criticized, doesn't care about threats or sickness. A tough one. Me hace lo que el viento a Juárez. Aguas. Be careful. This is a very common expression. Aguas literally means waters. Be careful. If you're walking down the road and there's a big puddle, aguas, be careful. Sepa la bola. Who knows? Particularly used when someone asks about who damaged or destroyed something. Sepa la bola. Who knows? Sepa la bola. Fantástico. Let's continue. Ni yendo a bailar a Chalma. This phrase is used when there is no solution to a problem. Ni yendo a bailar a Chalma. Ni yendo a bailar a Chalma. La carne del burro no es transparente. This phrase is very popular, especially among Mexican children and young people. It is used whenever someone is blocking the view from others. For example, you go to the cinema and somebody is blocking you. Ya chupó faros. Someone died. If you hear this expression, ya chupó faros, means that somebody passed away. Continuemos. Let's continue. está padre. That means that something is good, fun, or cool. Yes, subscribe because this channel está padre. Don't forget I upload videos every week. Subscribe now. ¿Qué pedo? This is very popular and it can mean different things. If it is said angrily, it can mean, what's your problem, dude? Or what's your problem, punk? If it is said in a friendly manner, it can mean, how are you? ¿Qué pedo? ¿Qué pedo, mate? ¿Qué pedo, wey? Muy bien, my dear amigos. And that was all for today, my dear amigos. Thank you once again. Please, this channel is very padrísimo, so subscribe. In that way, I can continue publishing and preparing more videos for you. Muy bien, mis cuates. Very good, my dear friends, my brothers. We'll see you soon. Hasta la vista and look after yourself. Adiós.